Scott Morrison has flown to Japan to sign an historic defence pact to counter China's growing influence in the region. In a sign of how much weight the PM puts on the agreement, he made the trip despite having to quarantine for 2 weeks on his return.
Touchdown Tokyo. The Prime Minister has arrived in Japan for a flying 24-hour visit. Pandemic diplomacy demands a patriotic mask only briefly removed for official pictures. Today, meeting with business chief Dr. Mimura Akio.
Our economic relationship with Japan has very strong foundations and a very deep history.
The head of the International Olympics Committee, Thomas Bach, gave an update on the COVID-delayed Tokyo Games as Scott Morrison made a pitch for Queensland to play host in 2032.
To catch up and re-express our keenness and commitment from an Australian government point of view.
But the key reason for the visit is a meeting tonight with the new Japanese Prime Minister, Yoshihide Suga, to sign a defence cooperation agreement.
Australia's relationship with Japan is now absolutely critical in a world where we have a more aggressive and assertive China.
While Scott Morrison tends to external alliances, Australia's domestic spy agency is beefing up internal defences, warning those who work in sensitive fields that they may be targeted online.
Emily is a spy operating from another country.
In a first, ASIO is running an education campaign.
She's trying to cultivate Jack as a source and wants him to give away sensitive information.
The spy chief says adversaries are everywhere.
Many countries are engaged in espionage.
But one is more active than most at home and abroad. Chris Yeoman, Nine News.